So I was going to do a live video, but I decided since we're going to be going through the backwoods area that I'm not going to do a live video. So we're in the Demon right now. We got a full tank of race gas in here because we are at Texas 2K.
Off the Remy, had up at post, had to hit my old town, lived up the news.
Alright, what's up Dream Chasers? Kevin Van Voorhis here for another video for you guys today. So I'm in the Demon with my buddy Eric. Dave is in the Trackhawk with Kennedy and Marvin behind me. We are on our way to our own meet, which we're going to be late for because Kevin cannot be on time to anything. If you know me, I'm always fucking late. Literally, always. Always late. Even when I try to be on time, I'm always late. So, anyways, let's get right into it. I'm going to show you the picture right now. So, first of all, I got to give a shout out to Sinister _ Lifestyle, a.k.a. Kyle. You can follow him on YouTube or Instagram. And I actually met him for the first time finally last night. It's so cool when you, like, talk to people through Instagram or YouTube and you finally meet a bunch of people. And I met a ton of people, so it's fucking awesome. Tonight is going to be wild. The meet that we're holding is going to be nuts. That's going to be a separate video. I've got a Texas 2K video. That's a separate video. We've got some more videos coming out. Those are separate videos, plus all the stuff that David's been doing. If you guys are not following me on Instagram or Snapchat, you need to because I've been posting like a madman the past couple days. So make sure you guys are following me at KellyBoyKev. Anyways, I'm dropping the picture. Here it is. So there it is, people. The 2020 wide body Dodge Charger Hellcat. There it is. It's real. I have to apologize because I did not think it was going to happen. Now, I don't think the CUDA or any of the other crazy shit is going to happen, but I was wrong. And like I said, if Driveway Demons was correct in the Dodge wide body Charger, then I would be like, you know what? I apologize. It was just my opinion. It's nothing crazy. I can admit when I'm wrong, unlike other people or other YouTubers. So, first impressions. What did you think when I showed you the picture?
It's ugly.
I don't know. It's not... And again, this is just with camouflage and stuff on it. Let me flash the picture again here. But, let me... I don't know. The front bumper looks like a Trackhawk bumper, which that's okay. With the little like slit across the front to let air in, which okay, I get it. So obviously it looks like they're gonna be probably 717 horsepower. So that little bump up. I'm pretty sure there's not gonna be a red eye version. Maybe there is. I don't think so though, but maybe there is. Which would be kind of cool. Obviously 797 horsepower, basically it's a Demon motor. That would be really cool in a four-door. I don't know if they would do it just because I don't know about the market. Red eyes aren't exactly like selling like hotcakes. You know, a lot of them are sitting out right now. But, you know, my initial thoughts, it looks meh, it looks okay. Obviously, you throw some airbags on it and you slam that bitch to the floor, that's gonna look super nice. It is nice though that it'll have 315s, it looks like all the way around, just like the wide body Hellcats, which is cool. Same wheels, tire setup. So that's nice. You can throw a fatter tire underneath the car already without having to do too many modifications, which is nice. So I'm hoping for maybe a little bit upgraded interior since it is gonna be a 2020. However, I don't really know. That's a good question. So I'm hoping they redo it. The new Dodge Charger Challengers, the dash, which like you guys see this dash, this is like a vinyl-ish. They put like a leather, kind of like leather on the top, kind of like how the Trackhawk is, which is nice. It makes it feel a little bit more luxurious because obviously, you know, Hellcats and stuff, you're paying 70, 75. A red eye, you're paying, you know, 85, 90 grand for it. So Dodge should have stepped up the plate a little bit. But, you know, this is nice. If you get a red eye, hopefully this is an option on the Charger, is the Alcantara steering wheel. I love this. This is the best thing ever, especially when you have it, the heat on. It's great. But everything else, I mean, basically, I'm pretty sure this is the last refresh for the Charger and the Challenger before they move into their next rendition of the Charger and the Challenger. So, from what I understand, they're supposed to be doing a new, updated, refreshed look on both of them in 2021, maybe 2022. So, for the Dodge Charger, it's probably going to have the same... You know, the only difference is going to be the fenders and the front and rear bumpers. That's really it. Everything else, I guarantee is going to be the same. It's just like the Challenger. What are you doing, bro? Bro, this traffic in Houston can suck a dick. But it's just like the Challenger. You know, from David's 2016 Challenger that he had, his Hellcat, to... You know, even the Demon and then the Red Eye that we spec'd out, which we didn't end up buying, there's really not much of a difference as far as like the looks and stuff. The headlights are the same, the taillights are the same. The only difference is like the bumpers and the fenders. And then that's really it. And I'm assuming it's going to be the same thing for the Chargers as well. Oh, that's why. We got a little cop action over here. I've seen more cops this weekend in Houston than in my entire life. So. Shout out to this officer over here doing his job. So shout out to you. But that's the update for the Charger Hellcat. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think. I don't know. I'm kind of iffy on it. I think, you know, maybe, I don't know, maybe in like a Go Mango or Purple or that new Sublime color they're re-releasing would be a cool one. But I don't know. I'm curious to see. I do know that the Trackhawk is going to be coming in a wide body version when they redo the facelift in 2021, 2022, which is going to be, that's a wide body option. So obviously Dodge has figured out everybody loves the wide body. I think the wide body on the Challengers looks, it's like the last piece of the puzzle that made that car perfect. So I think the Red Eyes and the Demons, It's like what else could you do to it? I really don't know. Besides like upgrade the interior and change that. It's just a good looking car, and it's gonna be hard to upgrade to the next thing. And in my opinion, at least, it's like how do you make something better without fucking it up? I'm hoping they don't fuck it up. I'm excited for the new Trackhawk in a couple years. That'll be awesome. And then because I know that will probably be getting the Red Eye engine. It's gonna be called a high output version. But it's gonna be cool. So I'm excited. You know, am I gonna get the new 2020 wide body Charger? No. Okay, I'm still trying to work on my fix. Is it cool that they're having that as an option? Absolutely. But just like the wide body Challengers, you're paying, you know, I think it's $6,500 to $7,000 just for the option. So it's gonna look sick, absolutely. But I personally, you know, I don't need another Charger. But it's gonna look sick, and I'm excited what Dodge is continuing to do with their Hellcat lineup. And I'm excited to see what they also do in the future. And I'm waiting for them to introduce a new car to the lineup, because it's about time. It's not going to be a CUDA, but I'm interested to see kind of what they drop next. All right, so for the rest of the video, I'm going to talk about TX2K a little bit. I'm not going to go through everything because those are separate videos. But if you have never been to TX2K, whether it's at the drag strip because we just got done at Houston Motorsports Park, or if it's in Mexico, dude, I'm telling you, you need to come. And I've been wanting to go forever, and this is all of our first times. And it's definitely worth the trip. You know, I know I'm probably gonna leave tomorrow morning. Turn left onto Critic Road. I don't know if Dave's gonna stay a little longer, but man, seeing like some of the roll racing and stuff at the event today, like the Vipers and GTRs and Lamborghinis, it's like holy fuck. It's like if you think you have money, go there and they'll be like, ha, you're right. Like, Jesus, it's insane the amount of money and stuff that is there in cars. And there's all different types. Like, you got JDM, you got American, you got old school muscle, you've got new school muscle, you've got European. It's insane. Every car you could think of is there. Super crazy. So, met a lot of cool people today there, which was awesome. And I'm excited to come back next year. But make sure you guys check out, keep a lookout for all the videos that are going to be dropping on my channel and David's channel. Dave's going to have some really awesome cinematic stuff that he's going to be working on probably for the next week and a half or so. But, you know, just if you do come down here and you do decide to go to Mexico and race, be very, very careful of the group of people you go with. They've were arresting people left and right yesterday and towing the shit out of people's cars also. So just be careful of who you go with and make sure you have a good group of people you're gonna go with.
I thought y'all were cool getting the fucking trailer in. Watch this.
I know. So that's it for today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you guys think of the new wide body charger. And also if you guys are at TX2K, let me know you're here. And if you've never been, also let me know. So anyways, thank you guys for watching today's video. My name is Kevin Van Voorhis. This is my homie Eric. What's your snap? Instagram.
Four Door Duran.
Follow Four Door Duran. Follow me at Cali Boy Kev. We are going to go head to our meet, which we're going to be late for. It starts in 12 minutes, and we're out this bitch.